about to get a big new showcase for contemporary art. A new museum opens this weekend featuring the work of major artists from the past 6 decades, all from the private collection of a longtime arts patron. Jeffrey Brown takes us there for a preview.
Billionaire art collector Eli Broad still remembers how he managed to acquire this early painting by modern master Roy Lichtenstein.
A Parisian collector who won a lot of money for it. I wasn't willing to pay that, so what I did is I wrote a check for X million dollars and said, you could take the check, send me the art, or tear it up.
Really?
And we ended up with the art.
Not something that most of us can do, but Eli Broad can and has for more than 4 decades. The results can now be seen in the brand new $140 million Broad Museum in Los Angeles. Designed by the firm of Diller, Scofidio, and Renfro, it features an outer honeycomb veil that allows natural light to filter in, a floor for storage of artworks that visitors can peer into, and 30 galleries filled with big names in modern and contemporary art. Andy Warhol, Keith Haring, Kara Walker, Jeff Koons, and many others, including Jasper Johns.
A number of these, I understand, were in your home.
They were indeed.
Sorry about that.
They were.
Why do you make that face?
Well, I decided we want the best work to be shown to the public, so we stripped a lot of work off our walls. I want it seen by the largest audience possible.
It's a long way from Eli Broad's modest childhood home in Detroit, where, he says, there was no art on the walls. The son of Jewish Lithuanian immigrants, Broad graduated from Michigan State University, married Edie Lawson, and started a business building tract homes in the suburbs of Detroit. It grew into KB Homes, one of the nation's largest home builders. He later created Sun America, a large investment company. It all propelled Broad onto the Forbes list of wealthiest people in the world. Last year, his net worth was estimated at over $7 billion. He's a major philanthropist in education and medicine, as well as the arts, one known for keeping a strong, even controlling hand in his various projects.
We've pledged to give 75% of our wealth away during our lifetime.
And you're sort of smiling as you say that. Is it fun, a fun thing to do, to give it away?
I see it as an investment rather than just charity.
What's an investment? What do you mean? An investment in what?
You want a return in education. You want to see scientific and medical research breakthroughs. In the art, you want to share it with the broadest possible public to get more people interested in art.
This is a work by Los Angeles artist Robert Therian.
The Broads began collecting art in the 1970s, and for the last 26 years have relied on the professional advice of curator Joanne Heiler, who will now serve as director of the new museum. She showed me one of the more whimsical pieces in the collection.
So under the table, it's a, what, child's eye view or something?
It does feel like a child's eye view, an almost Alice in Wonderland experience.
Over time, the Broads acquired 2,000 works of art, adding a new piece almost every week. And the collection has long functioned as a kind of lending library, with some 8,000 loans to more than 500 art institutions. Heiler says it's been rapid-fire buying, but always with an eye toward a public mission.
We're deep investors in an artist's work, so we really want to know what we're getting into when
investors we buy. Investors in the sense of, not as in buying it to make money, but
investors in the sense of art history, investors in the sense of trying to promote their work to the public, not in any financial sense.
Do you feel that's a big role, to be part of art history? Is it that grand in a sense?
Well, you shoot for that, you aspire for that. And again, when you're in the realm of contemporary art, you can't be sure, and you have to like not being sure all the time.
I like these snap lines.
One of the artists the Broads have collected in depth is Mark Bradford, who we visited in his huge studio in an industrial part of South Los Angeles. His scorched earth painting about the aftermath of the LA riots is featured in the inaugural exhibit at the museum. As a young artist just out of grad school, Bradford said he'd heard of the Broads, but
it was all just folklore to me. Mm-hmm. The Broads, the Broad collection.
Yeah. You didn't know what that meant.
I didn't know. Yeah. I probably the first time I said the Broad, I probably said the Broad.
Years later, he says this of the Broad's influence.
I think it's important when collectors collect in depth of an artist, because you don't feel like they're just doing baseball cards. I have one of this and one of this and one of this. You really feel like they're committed to your work over the long period. And that, for me, means something, because you can see your growth in the work where it's
a little bit.
Sure, you go, oh, that was good, or oh, I'm a little bit better. Oh, but you can see
just
this.
Just looking in one place, in one his place. Collection.
L.A. Times art critic Christopher Knight applauds that kind of long-term commitment, but wishes the overall collection reached beyond so-called blue-chip art and deeper into what's been produced in Los Angeles.
The primary limitation of the collection is that it's a market-driven collection, which is a very narrow sliver of the very active art world of the last 30 years. And I wish it had a greater representation of art that has been produced in Los Angeles. There is nowhere to go where one can see the evolution of the development of art in Los Angeles. There isn't one, and there should be.
Eli Broad, though, is obsessed with developing LA as a leading capital of the art world. The new building is part of an arts district he's helped create, stretching along Grand Avenue in downtown Los Angeles, and including Disney Concert Hall and the Museum of Contemporary Art.
What was the idea that you wanted
to
create?
The idea was to create a vibrant center for a region of 14 million people, and I consider this to be the cultural and civic center for the region of 14 million people.
Which it didn't have.
It did not have before.
Whether the new Broad helps further that vision for downtown is one of the big question marks as it opens this weekend. From Los Angeles, I'm Jeffrey Brown for the PBS NewsHour.